Hello student, this is the ninth part of concept of number theory. Today I am going to explain some problems based on remainder theorem and factor theorem in number theory. See a remainder theorem. If a polynomial f of x is divided by x minus alpha, where alpha is any complex number, then the remainder is f of alpha. So what remainder theorem says here? If f of x is divided by a linear polynomial x minus alpha, obviously your remainder is f of alpha. That says remainder theorem. Some question. By using remainder theorem, you can find remainder without actual long division. But important thing is, your divisor should be linear. Means your divisor should be of the form ax plus r minus b only. For example, your divisor is x minus alpha, the remainder is f of alpha. How you got proof? I already explained in the concept of polynomials. Okay. Now I want to write note 1, note 2, note 3, nana. Note 1. If f of x is divided by x minus alpha, then the remainder is f of alpha. This is note 1. Note 2, if f of x is divided by x plus alpha, then the remainder is f of minus alpha. Note 3, if f of x is divided by ax minus b, important nana, then the remainder is f of b by a. Should take care of this. Proof already given, Nana, in polynomial concept. Last one, fourth one. I will write fourth one. If f of x divided by ax plus b, the remainder is minus f of b by a. Okay. Here one example problem is given, Nana. Find the remainder when 6x cube plus 2x square minus 7x plus 1 divided by x minus 1. Okay. Let f of x is taken as 6x cube plus 2x square minus 7x plus 1. Okay. According to remainder theorem, when f of x divided by x minus 1, your remainder is f of 1 only. Just you want to find f of 1, Anna. F of 1 equal to q 1 square minus 7 into 1 plus 1. That is 6 plus 2 minus 7 plus 1. 6 plus 2, 8, 8 plus 1, 9, 9 minus 7, that is equal to 2. Therefore, the remainder is 2. Okay. Next one is factor theorem, important theorem for number theorem point of view. This is the one of the application of remainder theorem. Okay. What factor theorem saying? F of x is a polynomial in x. If there exists a complex number a, so that f of a equal to 0, then x minus a is the one of the factor of f of x. Okay. Actually, what it's saying that f of x is a polynomial, if there exists a number a, so that f of a, the value of f of a equal to 0, directly conclude that x minus a is a factor of f of x. That is factor theorem. I will prove here only. I already proved, but again I want to prove. Okay, listen Nana. Yeah. F of x is divided by x minus a. Assume that your quotient is q of x and remainder is f of a by remainder theorem. By division algorithm, I can say that f of x is equal to x minus a into q of x plus f of a. Sorry. F of a only. Equation number 1. So, observe students, for example, 515 equal to 7, 2s are 14 plus 1 only. Here, I can't say that 7 is factor of 15 because some plus 1 is there. What is the meaning of that? 15 divided by 7, 2 is the quotient, 1 is the remainder. That's why I can't say that 7 is the factor and 2 is the factor. If it's 0 is there here, I can say 7 is the factor of 15 and 2 is the factor of 15. For example, 15 can be written as 5 into 3 plus 0 only. Here I can say that 5 is the factor of 15, 3 is the factor of 15. If this is equal to 0, then only I can say that x minus factor of f of x. Or q of x is also a factor of f of x. According to, 1 minute. Yeah. According to statement of factor theorem, f of a equal to 0. But given f of a equal to 0, then equation 1 becomes f of x equal to x minus a into q of x plus 0. What is the meaning of that? That is x minus a is a factor of f of x. Important, Anna. Important. Okay. So I am concluding here that, listen Anna. Yeah, this is the theorem. Now I want to conclude here. F of x is a polynomial. Find the value of f of k, just k. Instead of x you write k in the polynomial. If you got 0. In other words, I can say that k is the 0 of the polynomial. In this case, you can say that x minus k is the one of the factor of f of x. Means what? F of x equal to x minus k into some polynomial. Okay. One more important thing, Nana. F of x is a polynomial. I found just f of minus k. If I got 0, then I can say that x plus k is one of the factor of f of x. That is important. X plus k is the one of the factor of f of x. Okay. F of x is given a polynomial. I got f of 2 value. I got equal to 0. Then I can conclude that x minus 2 is the one of the factor of f of x, or f of x can be written as x minus 2 to some polynomial. Okay, that is one thing. F of x, a polynomial is given. For example, I found f of 3, I didn't get 0. Then what is conclusion? X minus 3 is not a factor, is not a factor. Factor of f of x, okay? I hope people understood. I want to write note 1, note 2, note 3 here. Okay. Yeah, for polynomial f of x, number 1, f of alpha equal to 0, then x minus alpha is a factor of f of x. second one, f of minus alpha equal to 0. Then what is the factor? Nana, x plus alpha, should take care. E is a factor of f of x. Third one, important one, f of b by a equal to 0. Most of students will confuse, nana, f of x is a polynomial, they found the value of f of b a. If they got 0, then conclude that x minus b by a is the one of the factor. Okay, but this is not right representation. What should write, nana? Ax minus b is the one of the factor. Okay, then ax minus b is a factor of f of x. Fourth one, f of minus b by a equal to 0. What happened, nana? What I can say, f of minus b by a equal to 0, x plus b by a is one of the factor. Our general method, we should write as ax plus b is the one of the factor. Ax plus b is the one of the factor. So this is important. Okay. I hope people understood. Yeah, next one. Listen, students. Yeah. Example. Best example. F of x equal to x square minus 5x plus 6. Just find f of 2. I do one thing. Find f of 1. 1 minus 5 plus 6. 2. Not equal to 0. What is the conclusion? X minus 1 is not a factor. Of f of x. Okay. Just find f of 2. Four minus 10 plus 6. 10 minus 10, 0. Therefore, x minus 2 is a factor. Is a factor of f of x. What is the meaning of that, none here? X square minus 5x plus 6 should be equal to x minus 2 to some polynomial, first degree polynomial, just like I will write u of x. I hope you have understood. Okay. Yeah, what I got here, f of 2 I got 0, then I concluded that x minus 2 is one of the factor. Find f of 3, nana, here, 9 minus 15 plus 6, 15 minus 15, 0 only. What is my conclusion? X minus 3 is a factor of f of x. Okay, actually this is second degree. Already we got two linear factors, means x square minus 5x plus 6 equal to first factor into second factor is some constant coefficient, but in this problem k should be 1 only. Okay, I hope people understood now. How can you use factor theorem? That is very 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 important. Okay, now I will prove important theorems. Those are useful to solve problems in number theory. Okay students, I am now going to explain some important prove that x minus y is a factor of x power n minus y power n for small n belongs to capital N. So I will prove, nana, important this important result. One by one I will prove. Actually, what do you want to prove, nana? X minus y is the one of the factor of x power n minus y power n. Means what? X power n minus y power n should be equal to x minus y into some polynomial in x and y. If x and y are taken as integers, then I can say that x minus y into some integer. How to prove it? First of all, do one thing, Nana. Put n equal to 1. What happened? X power 1 minus y power n equal to x minus y only, no? Into 1, I can say. Put n equal to 2. X square y square equal to x minus y into x plus 1. Put n equal to 3. X cube minus y cube. A cube minus b cube formula. A minus b into a square plus ab plus b square only. Put n equal to 4. X power 4 minus y power 4. Which is same as x square whole square minus y square whole square. A square minus b square. A minus b into a plus b. Again, this is in the form of a square minus b square. X plus y into x minus y. Into x square plus y square. What is the meaning of this? If n is 1, x minus y is divisible by x minus y, or x minus y is a factor of x minus y. N equal to 2, then x minus y is a factor of this. N equal to 3, x minus factor of this. N equal to 4, x minus y is a factor of this. By using these things, what I can conclude that x minus y is a factor of x power n minus y power n, means x power n minus y power n equal to x minus y into something, some polynomial. But what I did, this is called verification method. N equal to 1 true, for n equal to 2 it is true. For n equal to 3 it is true, for n equal to 4 it is true, n equal to 5, n equal to 7. But that is not called proof, no. Theoretically, you want to prove. What I did is verified. I verified for n equal to 1, n equal to 2, n equal to 3, n equal to 4. I got all R satisfying the given condition. But theoretically, you want to prove that x power n minus y power n is divisible by x minus y, or x minus y is a factor of x power n minus y power n. Students, this is an important. Step 1. X power n minus y power n is a polynomial in x and y. Because n is stated a natural number. But to solve this type of problems, assume that this is a polynomial in one variable. Because while defining the factor theorem, what I did, Nana? F of x is a polynomial in x. In one variable polynomial. Then only can use Riemann theorem, factor theorem. Okay. So, what is my assumption? I assume that this is a polynomial in x. Actually, it is a polynomial in x and y, even though assume that this is a polynomial in x only. Assume that y is just like constant. Just like constant. We have to assume that only x is varying. Okay. Now, what you got? F of x minus y power n. Just to find f of k. For example, d equal to 0. Then from factor theory, we can say that x minus k is the one of the factor of f of x. Or you find f of minus k, it equal to 0. Then you can say that x plus k is the one of the factor of f of x. Okay. For this problem, just to find f of y. Just to find f of y. If it is not equal to 0, then what is my conclusion? X minus y is the not a factor of f of x. If equal to 0, then what I can say, x minus is one of the factor of f of x. Okay. Just I will find f of y. What we should do, instead of x you want to write y, that's all. Here x is then y power n minus y power n. Irrespective of n, 0 only, no? For every small n belongs to capital N. Y power n minus y power 0 only, no? For every n belongs to n. What is the meaning of that? F of y equal to 0. I got f of x is a polynomial in x. I found f of y. I got 0. From factor theorem, what I can say, x minus y is one of the factor of f of x. So, f of y equal 0, what n it is happening? N is any natural number. What is the conclusion? Therefore, x minus y is a factor of x power n plus y, sorry, x power n minus y power n for n belongs to capital N. Very, very, very important. Very, very, very important. For example, x power 2021 minus y power 2021 given. Directly you can say that this is x minus y into some polynomial. This is 2021 degree polynomial. This is linear. This should be 2020 polynomial. Whatever it may be. But directly I can say no, x minus y is a factor of this. Because this is in the form of a power n minus b power n. A power n minus b power n divisible by a minus b. Just now I proved. So this is one of the important result. Okay. Next, second result. I will put in next page. Important, second also important, prove that x plus y is a factor of x power n plus y power n if n is odd natural number. Just I will write odd means odd natural number. Proof. Yeah, x power n plus y power n is a polynomial in x and y. But I will assume that this is a polynomial in only in x. Okay, see, observe students, f of x is a polynomial. I found f of minus y value. It equals 0, for example. Then what is conclusion from factor theorem? X plus y is the one of the factor of f of x. Understood? Okay. What I want to do? I want to find f of minus y. What I am doing now here, instead of x, I want to write minus y. Minus y power n plus y power n. If it equal to 0, then only I can say that x plus y is one of the factor of x power n plus y power n. Now my question is, for what values of n, this expression becomes 0? What values of n? I will write here again. What values of n, this expression becomes 0? I will show you. Put n equal to 2. Minus y square plus y square. Minus y square only. Y square equal to 2y square. This never 0 unless otherwise y equal to 0. Okay. The exponent may not, y may not be 0. No, that is not big problem for us. That's why I can say that it is not equal to 0. Take n equal odd, that is 3, minus y power 3 plus y power 3 given. Minus y power 3 minus y multiplied 3 times minus y cube you will get plus y cube equal to 0. Means when this happening, you know, n is equal to even, it is, n is 2, not getting 0. N equal to 3, giving 0. N equal to 4, won't get 0. N equal to 5, will get 0. What is the meaning of that? If n is an odd number, automatically the summation becomes 0. That I will write. I hope you people understood. Or I will write here. If n is odd, minus y whole power n equal to minus y power n only. Okay, that's what I can write, minus y power n plus y power n for n odd. For odd n, that equal 0 only, for odd n. What is the meaning of that? Therefore, x plus y is a factor of f of x, means that is that x power n plus y power n if n is odd. Okay. I hope you people understood. Okay, now I want to explain one problem based on this concept. Example, prove that 2 power n plus 1 is divisible by 5 for odd n. Okay, listen students, proof for this, what you want Prunana? 2 power n plus 1 is a multiple of 5. 5 is some integer. That should prove for what n, Nana? For n odd. So I will take n equal to 1 for example. What happened? 2 power 2 plus 1 that equal to 4 plus 1 that equal to 5, which is a multiple of 5. Which is the multiple of 5? Means what the meaning of that? If n equal to 1, this is divisible by 5. Take n equal to 3. I can't take n equal to even numbers. No? Here n is odd. If you take n equal to even also, I will show you. 2 power 2, that is 4 plus 1, that is equal to 16 plus 1. Yeah, 2 power 2, no? 2 to the 4, no? 2 power 4 plus 1, okay. 2 power 4, 16. 16 plus 1, that is equal to 17. Which is not a multiple of 5. Means what happened? When n equal to 2, this number is not divisible by 5. Take n equal to 3, Nana. So what happened? 3 to the 6, 2 power 6 plus 1, 64 plus 1, 65, which is a multiple of 5. What is the meaning of that? If n is odd, the number is divisible by 5. N is odd, the number is a multiple of 5. But what I did, that is verify. I verified. But theoretically, we need to prove, Nana. I will prove it. Observe. Important. Okay. 2 power n plus 1 can be written as 2 power 2 whole power n plus 1. No problem. A power m whole power n equal to a power m n only, which is same as 4 power n plus 1, which is same as 4 power n plus 1 power n. No, I will write clearly. I will write clearly, Nana. This is in the form of 2 power n plus 1 power n. If n is odd, 2 power n plus 1 power n is divisible by 2 divisible by x plus 5. Just now we proved, no? I will show you. This one only. Okay, what the meaning of that? 4 power n plus 1 power n equal to a power n plus b power n or x power n plus y power n. X plus 5 is some integer. X means 1, y means 1, x plus 5 is some integer. That is equal to 5 into some integer. I hope people understood. What is my final conclusion? I will write here. I hope you people understood, no? I'll do one thing. I will write here. No problem. So, final conclusion. Therefore, 2 power 2 power n plus 1 is divisible by 5 if n is odd. Okay. So, this is the example problem in number theory. Okay, this problem is fully based on this concept. Okay, Ranana. So, next completed, and next one is, I want to prove another result. Two results completed. Third result I want to prove, Nana. Prove that x. Plus y is a factor of x power n minus y power n if n is even. Easy proof only, Nana. What we should do? Let's assume that given polynomial is only in x. Okay, just I want to find f of minus y. If it equal to 0, then I can conclude that x plus y is the one of the vector of f of x. So, instead of x, you write minus y, minus 5 power n, minus 5 power n. What values of n, it becomes 0. That is interesting thing. Minus 5 power n, minus 5 power n. Should be 0. Put n equal to 3, Nana. Minus 5 cube, minus 5 cube. Minus 5 cube, minus 5 cube. Not equal to 0 only. Put n equal to 2. Put n equal to 2. What happened? Minus y square only. Minus y square cancel. We will get 0. What is the meaning of that? If n equal to even, it is giving 0. Okay, I will write 0 if n is even. What is the conclusion? Therefore, x plus y is a factor of x power n minus y power n if n is odd. Very, very, very important, Nana. Very, very, very important. Okay. Yeah, result 4, Nana. Prove that x plus y is never a factor of x power n plus y power n for small n belongs to capital N. Same way you can prove, Nana. Let f of x equal to x power n plus y power n. Just find f of y value. If f of y equal to 0, then I can say that x minus y is the one of the factor of f of x. Try to find y value. Y power n plus y power n. That is equal to 2 into y power n. This is never 0. No value of n. No value of n. This is never 0. And equal 0 when y equal 0. You know? We are not saying about y. What values of n is happening? So that means that if no value of n, so 2 into y power n gives 0. That means what the meaning of that? X minus y is not a factor of x power n plus y power n. Okay. So important theorem. Yeah, now I want to prove some problems, students, here. Here some problems are given. So I proved first one already. Second one also completed. Third one also completed. Already I proved now 2 power n plus 1 divisible by 5 if n is odd integer. Okay. And fourth one. Yeah. Prove that 2 power 4n minus 1 divisible by 15. 2 power 4n minus 1 is a multiple of 15. So prove, don't want verify, I want prove. Theoretically, I want prove. 2 power 4 whole power n, I can write that one. Since a power m whole power n equal to a power mn only, this is nothing but 6 power n minus 1. This is nothing but 6 power n minus 1 power n form. I will write. This is in the form of 2 power n minus b power n. So you know that 2 power n minus b power n is divisible by a minus b if n is even or odd. If n, for n belongs to n, I can, small n belongs to capital N. For small n belongs to capital N. What is the meaning of that? 16 power n minus 1 power n is divisible by 16 minus 1, a minus b. 16 minus 1 into some integer, I can say. What is the meaning of that? 15 into some integer. So, what is the meaning of that? Divisible by 15 only, no? So, final conclusion I will write here. Therefore, 2 power 4n minus 1 is divisible by 15. Okay. Now, you people understood. Next, fifth problem. Okay, we want to prove that 4 power 4 power n minus 5 power 3 power n divisible by 131. This can be written as 4 power 4 whole power n minus 5 power 3 whole power n. This can be written as 256 whole power n minus 125 whole power n. This is the form of a power minus divisible by a minus b, I will write that into some integer. So already you know that a power n minus b power divisible by a minus b when even or odd. Subtraction 1, 3, 1 into integer. What is the meaning of that? Therefore, 4 power 4 n minus 5 power 3 n is divisible by 131. Okay.